This one comes from Jan. Jan asks, as we head into fall, what are some of your favorite family traditions when it comes to the changing of the seasons?
Traditions for the changing of seasons. Oh, man. You know, we live in Southern California, so the changing of seasons isn't as dramatic as you get in Washington where you get back east. So we don't really get snow. It's kind of summer, except for maybe 3 months of the year. But we do get a little fall color because we've got these oak trees back here, which lose their leaves. And you know what one of our traditions is? I love to get together with the kids and we gather up all the acorns that fall from the oak trees. And our acorns are pretty monster acorns. They're hefty. And we'll gather them together and then I like to drill holes through them and then take some twine and thread them through the holes and I make like a whole like 9-foot garland of acorns to hang on the fireplace mantle for the fall. So it's great for Thanksgiving and then also for Christmas. And sometimes we'll string together popcorn and cranberries and things like that. So that's one of our traditions. How about you?
Nothing great. I mean, pumpkin patch back in Seattle. We put all our big winter jackets and rain jackets on and go out to the pumpkin patch and do the corn maze and all that as a family. I think we sort of do that every year.
Yeah.
I think only 1 year my mom just had the end of it and she just cut through the thing. She's like, we're not finding our way out. She's like, we're done.
Oh, she cut through the maze.
Cuts right through the maze. She walks
out. Yeah.
But.
Yeah. Our kids are getting a little bit older and so they don't go to the corn maze anymore.
Yeah.
One of the other things that we like to do is have a great big Thanksgiving dinner. And Chelsea's such an amazing cook and our kids like to cook too. We have Thanksgiving with some good friends. We visit family, see mom and dad, see my sisters, the ones that live close by. But we have this great big dinner, and we have some good friends, the Barretts, who come over. Sometimes we'll meet up in Colorado. Sometimes we've had dinner here. Sometimes we'll go up to Big Sur. This year, we might even go back to Cazenovia, New York.
Ooh.
And it's this little Norman Rockwell-looking town. It's so charming and quaint, and they've got snow and everything back there. Mm. And we just love to be with friends and make a great big turkey and make stuffing and pumpkin pie. Just love it. Thanksgiving is probably the greatest dinner of the year. How about you? You have big Thanksgiving plans?
Nothing crazy. I think just hanging out with Jolene. I don't know if we're going to go home this year. I think we're just going to stay local in California.
Okay.
Just have some friends. Friendsgiving.
Friendsgiving, nice.
Yeah, hang out with them, nothing.
You know, I got something else that I actually love to do, and this is much to the embarrassment of my children. On Halloween, October 31st, I like to celebrate a different holiday. October 31st is actually Reformation Day.
Okay.
Now, a lot of people don't know this, but I believe 1517, I think I've got the date right, October 31st is the day that the German monk Martin Luther nailed his 95 theses to the door of the church in Wittenberg, Germany. And that's where he had his points of discussion that he wanted to have with the church, which of course, this started a great big controversy and led to the Reformation. And what an important date, the Reformation.
Yeah.
This is when the truths of God's word and the gospel were discussed and unleashed. Copies of those 95 theses went everywhere, and it started a revolution within the church, obviously. And that's where you have not just the Roman Catholic Church, but from that came the Protestant Reformation. You've got Baptists and Methodists and Presbyterians and Lutherans and every other denomination. So I dress up in my Scottish kilt with my leggings and my my saddle shoes. I've got a white puffy sort of shirt tied with leather around the neck. And I dress up as a Scottish Covenanter.
And you know the accent. You've done the accent before, right?
I do. I do know the accent. Haggis Loch Ness Kilt. These are my Scottish words. And I actually start quoting a little bit of Luther every once in a while when the kids come for their trick-or-treating candy. Yeah. Kids, do you know about the Reformation? Let me tell you about it.
And everyone thinks you're just dressing up for Halloween.
They just think I'm dressing up for Halloween. And I tell them it's Reformation Day. Look it up. I don't know, that might be Irish. I was trying to be Scottish there.
Yeah.